this is my last session, so I'll be taking over the company accounting and partnership accounting in today's session, and that finishes the financial accounting area in your syllabus, and Ali will take over the management accounting area in your syllabus in two sessions, on 3rd and 6th January. So without waiting much time, so I'll straight away go ahead with the company accounting part. So I sent you two tutorials. One is company accounting, another one is partnership. So out of this, so please take the first the company accounting one, but which I sent the last. So I have sent second two editions. So take the latest edition. Okay. So we'll do the first question. So most of the students are struggling with PPE note and the revaluation part. So I want to emphasize how to tackle with those areas, and so that you have some sort of a comfort in doing your company accounting part. Okay. So the first question, land purchased for 10 million on 1st May 2010. So in your PPE note, where you record this one, so go to the PPE note. So you put it here, 10 million. So you put it all in rupees 1000. All in rupees 1000. So you go to the additions, 10,000. Okay. And the closing value is 10,000. Please do that for me. You'll definitely get a question pertaining to PPE note. So there can be some revaluation, some additions, some disposals at any point of time. So please brush up your knowledge. So how it linked to the cash flow statement, acquisition of non-current assets will come under investing activities. It's a cash outflow. So you put here 10,000. So additions are down on 10,000, closing balance will be 10,000. And in the cash flow statement, so I just want to link with these as well. So I take acquisition of land, it's a cash outflow, it will come under investing activities. We'll move to the next transaction, transaction number two. This land revalued to 12 million. So you have an opening balance 10,000. The opening balance 10,000. Take a revalue or not 12,000. You put 12,000 here. So the revaluation 2,000. So please copy this. So you have a revaluation surplus 2,000. So that 2,000 should go to other comprehensive income, 2,000. Remember, other comprehensive income, 2,000. And then in your statement of changes in equity, you have a total comprehensive income, 2,000. Remember. The closing balance is 2,000 in revaluation surplus. You bought 10,000 land and revalued to 2,000 at the revaluation surplus, 2,000. Take another comprehensive income, increase in revaluation surplus, 2,000. And statement of changes in equity, you take 2,000. And the closing balance is 2,000. Now we come to the tricky part here. So you might get 1 hour of those. Okay. Is the opening balance ekak kiyeda? Opening balance ekak 12,000. Opening balance ekak 12,000. Hari da? Opening balance ekak 12,000. And now this need to be revalued to 9. So ethoda closing dana 9. closing down a nine. The revaluation deficit, evaluation deficit kiyala negative 3000 brackets 3000 brackets 3000. So please do understand, this is very very important. So this is the second time revaluation, where you have first time revaluation surplus of 2000. The initially kalapu revaluation eke surplus ekak thiyena 2000. Second time revaluation ekak karama you get a deficit of 3000. So what do you do then? You set off that out of this 3000, 2000 from your revaluation surplus. So methana liyanna negative 2000. Negative 2000. Negative 2000. Negative 2000. Ithuru daha, the balance 1000 is considered as a revaluation loss. Yanna, other expenses, revaluation loss. Revaluation loss 1000. Okay, so AKN other expense, remember revaluation loss 1000 will come under other expense, and you need to be disclosed in note number one. Remember, you need to disclose this in note number one, revaluation loss. What is that? The opening balance ekak like thiyena revaluation surplus ekak like 2000. Harada opening balance ekak like thiyena 2000. Total comprehensive income ekak like brackets 2000. The closing balance becomes zero. Closing balance becomes zero. Closing balance becomes zero. The carrying value is 9 million. Carrying value is 9 million. That's how you record in this. And next scenario. Is 9 million acre revalue karanama 15,000? 9 million acre revalue karana 15,000. The opening balance is 9 million. Revalue karanne kiyeda 15 ma revaluation ekak kiyeda 6000 revaluation ekak 6000 9 million land ekata the latest revaluation was 9 million now it revalued to 15000 the revaluation surplus ekak enawa 6 but last year ke you have a revaluation loss pnl ekata ge loss ekak thiyena A loss ekak other expenses will negative will remember reversal of evaluation loss negative 1000 remember negative 1000 A or the revaluation surplus ekak aavoth last year ke deficit ekak tibbot it should need to be reversed it need to be reversed. Yeah, so you need to reverse 1000. Thara kiya kithuruda 5000 kithurui e 5000 yanama increase in revaluation surplus. Increase in revaluation surplus 5000. Increase in revaluation surplus 5000. Opening balance is 0. Total comprehensive income 5000 closing balance ekak This is what I'm expecting this year. Revalued item might be selling this year. Revalued asset take up, sell karma. This hasn't been tested yet. I'm predicting. I don't know how far my prediction is correct or not, but I'm forecasting this can be the adjustment because none of the teachers are not taught this one yet. So can be tested because all the time examiner might give you a different version of revaluation. So if you are selling any revalued assets, so what is the value of the asset? What is the closing balance? 15,000. So go to the land, 15,000. Land, 15,000. Opening balance is 15,000. And you need to be minus this one as disposal. You put brackets, 15,000. So the balance is zero. Balance is zero. 15,000 land, 20,000. So what is the profit on disposal of land? Profit on disposal of land is 5,000. So proceeds you take as a cash inflow under investing activities, 20,000. 20,000. And further, if you are doing this one as an indirect method, so you need to minus profit, so from profit after tax. So it's basically cash flow from operating activities. So you start with profit before tax. And then less profit on disposal of land. How much? 5,000. Profit on disposal of land, you need to minus. You don't know profit before tax, from that you need to minus profit on disposal of the land. And statement of profit or loss, or other comprehensive income, well, the so you have other income, profit on disposal of land, on land, 5,000. And then, so what is the value in revaluation surplus here? Revaluation surplus 5,000. Revaluation surplus 5,000. A 5,000 you need to transfer to the retained earnings. Decrease in revaluation surplus brackets 5,000. Because since you don't have the assets, you remove these assets from your asset portfolio or fixed asset register, you need to remove your revaluation surplus because no longer asset is there with you. Yeah. So you remove that surplus here. Okay. And then you have revaluation surplus, you have retained earnings. Opening balance, you have 5,000 here. Revaluation surplus. And then write it down, transfer to retained earnings. You put minus 5,000, and transfer that to retainers. Transfer to retainers. Okay, so this may not be tested, I don't know, but they want to make it hard, they can give this. Next year onwards, the teachers will teach it. Okay? Right. Shall we go to the question number one, prepare financial statements? So please draw your format. Start with the statement of profit or loss and other comprehensive income for the year ending 31st March 2021. Start with sales, cost of sales, gross profit, distribution cost, admin expenses, other expenses, finance cost, profit before tax. Probably you will get a note number one for that. And income tax, note number two, profit for the period and other comprehensive income, changes in revaluation surplus, total comprehensive income. And you just write note number one, profit before tax has been calculated after deducting following expenses. That expenses including the following. So just give some space. Then you have income tax note. So income tax, provision for the year or under provision, give some space. Then you draw statement of changes in equity. So equity components, stated capital, revaluation reserve, general reserve, retained earnings, and leave some space. Name of the entity, statement of financial position. Start with non-current assets, PPE, right of use assets. Current assets, leave some space. And you have a total assets. And you have equity, stated capital, ordinary shares, reserves, probably retained earnings, general reserves, non-current liabilities, probably leave some space, current liabilities, leave some space. And you have a separate note on other payables, and there's a separate note on that. The economic structure, I hope you have a very familiar with these ones, okay? And then we come to expense schedule. Distribution cost, admin expenses, other expenses, finance cost, leave some space. And you have a property, plant and equipment note. So you start with land, trucks, fixtures and fittings according to this question. And you start with cost or value, valuation, opening balance, additions, leave some space, accumulated depreciation, leave some space, carrying amount. I'll give you 5 minutes time. So just draw the format or the templates what you are familiar with. In the meantime, if you have any doubts, you can put it in the chat box. Today, what I'm going to cover company accounting and partnership accounting areas. Most of the students are struggling in these areas. In the meantime, you need any clarification, you can put here on your chat box. I'll give you 5 minutes, so just draw the template, profit and loss or other comprehensive income, statement of changes in equity, and statement of financial position, and working on distribution expenses schedule, and PPE notes, and right of use asset note. And give more weightage towards your additional information in your company accounting question. And don't try to balance your company accounting question, never. In your exam, never. I'll give you 5 minutes. So just to put those in your answer scripts. So I start 8:55. Today's session is so important because I will cover the most the toughest areas in your syllabus. So don't leave. So try your best to stay in today's session. Today is my last session. In your management accounting areas will be covered by Ali on 3rd and 6th January. The requirements, statement of profit or loss, and other comprehensive income for the year financial year ended 31st March 2021, and statement of changes in equity for the financial year ended 31st March 2021, statement of financial position. For the financial year ended 31st March 2021. You don't know anything about company accounting, please focus this question, you will learn a lot. Trust me. There's a question. I'll do partnership after we cover this area. Shall we? 2 minutes more. And don't do your company accounting question as a first question in your exam paper, remember. And don't do this one as a last question in your exam paper. You need to try this question as a third question or second question, not as the first question. Yeah. Okay. Additional information. So you need to give more weightage on additional information. So don't give more weightage on these things. Other information. It should be additional information because more marks are allocated for these items 1 to 10. If you do this one, you will score roughly 60 to 70% of your marks. Do it properly. If you come across a situation where your time is gone, move to the next question. Okay? You will do slowly and try to get the understanding here. Inventory as of 31st March 2021 is 146,000. So what you go here, so go to working calculation of cost of sales. Calculation of COS. So if you use the workings, you can use the abbreviation. Don't worry about it. And you have your closing stocks. The closing stocks, remember, you use the cost. So you put 146,000. So 146,000. Now, and this includes a 31,000 of slow moving goods. So there is a cost. And this company, Mithinam Kamkor Limited, Vietnam, but it's okay, is trying to sell these slow moving damaged items to another company, but has not been satisfied in obtaining the reasonable offer. The best price it has been offered till the date of financial statement authorized was 22,000. So the selling price is 22,000, the cost is 31,000, but you need to incur a further 1,000. If you want to calculate the NRV, you take 22,000 minus 1,000, the NRV is 21,000. the cost is 31,000. So you need to bring your cost 31 to 21,000. So that means your real value of the inventory is not 146, it should be 136. So go to your balance sheet, go to your statement of financial position, put inventory 136. You put here minus 10,000. Minus 10,000. හරිද? දැන් inventory එකේ cost එක 146. ඒකෙන් එක item එකක් තියෙනවා 31,000 cost එකක් වෙච්ච එකේ NRV එක වෙනවා 21,000. So you need to bring this 31 to 21. That means the inventory value should decrease by 10,000. The correct inventory value is 136. Go to your expense schedule. Go to your expense schedule. Write it down. Inventory write-off. Come under other expenses, 10,000. Inventory write-off will come under other expenses, 10,000. Then go to the note number one. Go to note number one, inventory write-off. Inventory write-off, 10,000. So we finished the first one. Inventory value is 146, cost that directly goes to the calculation of cost of sales. Remember, to calculate cost of sales, you use cost. And then you have a slow moving item that has been for that purpose, you need to take the cost or NRV, whichever is lower. So 31,000 is the cost, NRV is 21,000. So you need to bring this 31,000 to 21,000. So there is an inventory write-off of 10,000 that need to be recognized as another expenses. Go to the expense schedule, put 10,000 and go to the note number one, inventory write-off 10,000. And then in your balance sheet, in your statement of financial position, you need to reflect inventory as 136,000. Yeah. Right. On to number two. The company has completed the extension of building with a total cost of 300,000 on 1st April 2020, which was correctly recorded. Now, go to the building. So here is 1.2. So this has been made on at the beginning of the year. So what you need to do is you go to the PPE note, go to the PPE note, go to the building, go to the building, opening balance 900,000. Opening balance 900,000. Additions done 3,000. That's been recorded. That's been recorded. And now, see this part clearly. You might get this time, never know. If you get the professional papers, they will give this type of a question. But the 200,000 payment to employees who directly involved in the construction of the building is included in the purchases during the year. So remember, if any employee who is directly involved in the construction of a building, the salary paid to that particular employee should not be taken as an expense as a salary. It needs to be capitalized into that particular non-current assets. So the addition should be not 33,000, it should be 3,000 plus 2,000, 200,000 answers 500,000. Addition should be 500,000. Meka dala tiyenne purchases worth. So what are you going to do now? You need to remove purchases 5,000. So go to your calculation of cost of sales. Purchases kira liyanna minus 200,000. Purchases selling adukara property plant and equipment are like that. That's all you need to do. Okay, so the this 200,000-300,000 already accounted. So opening balance is 1.23. So if you want to calculate the correct operating balance, it should be 900,000. 300 in additions. But in addition to that, 200,000 salary paid to employee need to be capitalized to the building account. So 200,000 also need to be added to under additions. That's why I put it all together, 300 plus 200, 500,000, you put it here. And if you have the purchase swelling, the purchase swelling remove. Okay. We'll come to item number 3. Fixtures and fittings were sold for rupees 30,000 on 1st October 2020. These were purchased in 30th June 2019 for 80,000. Proceeds from sales were included in error in revenue on the trial balance. Okay, go to sales, put minus 80,000. Do the easy one first. You put sales minus 80,000. Do that part first. Minus 80,000. Okay. This question gone. Give me a minute. I'll do it fast, the adjustments here. It's gone, give me a minute. So go to the inventory. So it is 136 here. And go to the inventory write-off. Sorry for this. It's happened, I don't know the reason for this. Inventory write-off. Come under the expenses, 10,000. And then go to the, here. And we write off 10,000 and go to the PP cost of calculation, cost of sales calculation. Minus 146,000. Second one. A building, so go to the building in PP note, opening balance is 900,000. Additions 500,000. So go to purchases. Purchases minus 200,000. Then go to sales. So that's what we are discussing. Go to sales minus 18,000. Minus 80,000. Now make a cost take here the 80. So you need to remove 80 from fixtures and fittings. Go to fixtures and fittings. Disposal minus 80,000. Minus 80,000. Cost take 80. You need to put minus disposal 80. Go to fixtures and fittings. The opening balance occur 200,000. Opening balance එක 400,000. So the closing balance එක කීයද? 400 වලින් 80 ගියාම 320. And buildings වල value එක කීයද? Add together. හරිද? දැන් මෙතන කියනවා. So what you need to do here is you need to calculate the depreciation on fixtures and fittings. You need to calculate the depreciation on fixtures and fittings. So when you calculate the depreciation, this 32,000 was there for the entire year. So the depreciation for that is 32,000 plus fixtures and fittings, 10% on cost. 10% on cost. And item which have been disposed, how long it was there for the current financial year? You dispose that on 1st October. So the 1st April in the 1st October with the masa hayak the 80,000 into 10%. 80,000 into 10%, 8,000. Half of that is 4,000. Is it clear? Originally, tibba 400,000. YU minus 80 because it's a disposer. The remaining one is 320. So 320 will the full year depreciation provide. And then item you disposed, you need to calculate depreciation for the current year. So 80,000 into 10%, 8,000, half of that, 4,000. So what is the answer? 32 plus 4,000, 36,000. 36,000. And when you bought this asset? 30th June. First July, roughly. So 1st July 2019 to 1st October 2020. How many months? How many years? Need the answer for you, from you. First July 2019 to 1st October 2020. I need answer from you. One year and 3 months. Is it clear? So, 1 year and 3 months. Altogether 10,000. So you need to remove disposal kiela 10,000. Remove disposal kiela 10,000. Now you go to the opening balance, fixtures and fittings, you put 40,000. Then the closing balance 40 plus 36 plus minus 10. So the carrying amount is 320 minus this. Okay, now tell me what is the profit or loss on disposal? What is the profit or loss on disposal? I need the answer from you. Here the carrying value, here the cost taker. Cost taker is 80. Cost taker 80. Accumulated depreciation is 10,000. Carrying value is 70,000. 70,000 is 30,000 value. So what is your profit or loss? Loss of 40,000. Loss of 40,000, you need to record where? Loss on fixtures and fittings. Other expenses, 40,000. Other expenses, 40,000. Go to note number one, loss on disposal of fixtures and fittings. Revenue should be deducted. Sorry, my mistake. Yeah. Revenue should be not 80. You're right. Sorry, my mistake. 30,000. Sales proceeds. Yes, you're right. Yes, my mistake. Sorry. Sales again, adu karanna one 30,000. The proceeds you sold for 30,000. Eka tamai sales or the you're right. Yeah. So the loss is 40,000. So write it here. 40,000. Loss on disposal is 40. Right, now we come to the worst part. Building was revalued to 900,000 on 31st March, last day. Last day revalued. Now tell me, what is the cost? Now, this is tricky part, okay? Building. Now, go to the building and tell me the accumulated depreciation for building 320. Opening balance 320 buildings. Okay. And the extension of the building and the payment to employees happen on the first day of the year. Extension of the building, how do you consider the rate of depreciation of furniture? Okay. Fixtures is 10%, it's given here. It's given as 10%. Right. So I'm moving to the building part. Okay. So the building, building value, cost taker 1.4 million. So building depreciation rate 5%. So can you calculate the depreciation for the building, please, everyone? Depreciation for the building, you take this into 0.05. 70,000. Depreciation for building is 70,000. Dakota, what is the accumulated depreciation for the building at the time of revaluation? Accumulated depreciation for the building at the time of revaluation here 390. Ekadana transfer of depreciation of revaluation kila minus 390. Minus 390. Remember. ඔපනින් බැලන්ස් එක 320 බිල්ඩින්ග්ස් වල අර බිල්ඩින් එකේ වැලියු එක තිනවා 1.4 මිලියන් ඒකට 5% එනවා 70,000. So මේ දෙකේ ටෝටල් එක තමයි transfer of depreciation revaluation කියලා දාන්න. ඒක දාන්න මෙතනට revaluation කියලා sorry transfer of revaluation කියලා minus 390. If you give that. Then now tell me what is the carrying amount of the building. Carrying amount of the building now is 10,100,000. 10.1 million. Carrying amount of the building is now 10.1 million. So me 10.1 million ne ka revalue ne ki yedde. 10.1 million එක revalue වෙන්නේ 900. Revaluation loss එක කීයද? Revaluation loss is equal 1.1 110,000. තව negative. Let's copy this down. This is the worst that can come. Okay. Yani asset එකක් තියෙන asset එක depreciation එක provide කරලා depreciation provide කරන net value එක තමයි you compare with the revalued amount. So revaluation loss is 110. Revaluation loss is 110. Now go to the trial balance. Go to the trial balance and tell me, do you have any revaluation reserve? Revaluation reserve එක කොච්චරද? Revaluation reserve එකක් තියෙනවා 60ක. Now go to your statement of changes in equity. Opening balance එකට දාන්න 60,000. Opening balance එකට දාන්න 60,000. ඉතින් යන්න other comprehensive income. Other comprehensive income. Put minus 60,000. What is the balance? Closing balance zero. Closing balance is zero. Closing balance is zero. And go to your other comprehensive income. Change in revaluation surplus minus 60,000. ඒක තමයි මෙතනටත් තියන්නේ හරි. So revaluation surplus එක fully absorb කරා. Your total loss is 110. Total loss 110 වලින් 60 ගත්තා revaluation surplus එක. Remained is how much? 50. So it's an other expense. So loss on revaluation. Really. 50,000. Loss on revaluation of really. Revaluation. Loss on revaluation of building. Last, the trucks you're using reducing balance method. So trucks and 400,000 opening balance. No additions, nothing. Closing balance is 400,000. Opening balance is 40,000. So it's about taking 10% kila kiyanne 400 minus 40. I can 25%. 400 minus 40, 360. 360 into 0.25, 90. So what is the total? 130. What is the carrying amount? 400 minus. Yeah. Cost එක 400, accumulated depreciation එක 40, carrying amount is 360. Trucks වලට එන්නේ 25% reducing balance. So 360 වලින් 25% කියලා කියන්නේ 9. Second. Sorry, my mistake. Sorry. 75. So 400 minus 75, answer is 325. So 325 into 0.25. So you put 81 here, it's enough, more than enough. So you put 81 is the depreciation, 81,250. 81,250. Sorry, my mistake. Trucks is 300,000. Trucks is 300,000. 300,000 minus 75 is 225,000 into 0.25. 56,250. $300,000 minus 131,250. The carrying amount is this. Heard that? Right. So shall we prepare a depreciation part? So write it down. Depreciation on building. Depreciation on buildings. Depreciation on trucks. Decision on fixtures and fittings. Depreciation on trucks seems to be a distribution cost. 56,250. Depreciation of fixtures and fittings is admin expenses. Depreciation building is also admin expenses. Yeah. Take the total of depreciation, but my recommendation not to put the depreciation in your note number one, because sometimes you might make mistakes in it. Depreciation of property, plant, and equipment, 137,250. Depreciation of PPE, 137,250. Note number 5. Vietnam Kamkar Limited sells tools for one of its customers and provide 90 days credit for the customer who has the option of returning goods without charge up to the date of payment. At the year end, the customer owes 120,000, which is included in revenue figure to this company. And having made one purchase in February in 2020. This is the case here. It's kind of revenue recognition part. So they send these goods to the customer. So after 90 days, they can recognize as a sales. But if it is not expired that time, you cannot recognize that one as a sales. Clear? You cannot recognize as a sales because the customer has the option to return the goods. So in that case, you just take this one as a sale or return basis. You send goods on sale or return basis part. Clear? So what you need to do here, so you need to reverse the 120 from your sales and your customer because it is not your sales. expiration time is not yet finished. So what you do here is from your sales, you need to minus, there is another minus here, 120,000. Go to the debtors, put your trade receivable debtors to minus 120. Right? And it's mentioned the sales toys to the customers at cost plus markup was 50%. If the cost is 100, you're selling for 150. So my question is, the cost is 100, profit is 50, you sold for 150. And you sold this one for 120,000. So 120,000 divided by 3, answer is 40,000. So what is your cost? 80,000. That is your cost. That is your closing inventory. So what you need to do here is you need to plus another 80,000. Because that also considered as on your stocks. So 136 plus 80,000 is your closing stocks. And go to your cost of sales calculation. Add 40, means minus 80,000. So the answer is closing stocks 226,000. If you send items on sale or return basis and you recognize that one as a sales and corresponding debtor, you need to reverse that. And the cost of the items you send, you need to take that one as your inventory. Remember, take that one as an inventory. Right. Now we come to the least part. The company entered into the lease agreement on 1st April 2020, obtained right to use of truck for the period of 4 years. According to the lease agreement, 250,000 was paid as a down payment as on 1st April. And the first installment of 500,000 on 51st. Not December, it should be March 2020. Please do amend that. Both payments have been debited to lease payments. So if you go to your trial balance, how much is the lease payment amount? 750. So that comprises the down payment of 250 and first installment of 500,000. Initial measurement of lease creditor is 3250. Useful life of the truck is 5 years. At the end of the lease period, truck is not transferred to the company. The lease interest for the years ending 31st March 2021 and 22 is given separately. No other entries have been made. Okay. Just make a note. Note number four, right of use asset. So the cost of the right of use asset has three elements: direct cost, down payments, initial measurement of the lease liability. So initial measurement of lease liability is 3250, down payment is 250. So what is the cost then? 3,500. The lease asset has not been transferred to the lessee. So in that case, you need to divide the cost with lease term. So what is the lease term? Lease term is 4 years. This divided by 4 years, how much? 875. So what is the carrying amount? This minus this. So carrying amount of the leases. Okay. So go to your note number 4. Just copy this down. 625. Okay. Right. Now go to depreciation. Go to here, depreciation of write-off use asset. Depreciation of write-off use asset. So it's a truck. How much is the value? Value is 875. Depreciation is this. Write-off use asset depreciation. And then write this down. Lease creditor. Lease creditor initial measurement is how much? 3250. 3250. 3250 is the initial measurement. And you need to calculate the interest for the current year. How much is the interest? Interest is 325. 325. What is the current year installment? You need to minus. Installment you need to minus. How much is it? 500,000. Initial measurement plus interest minus installment, you derive the closing balance. You write the closing balance. A closing balance, you separate it two sections, current and non-current. Current and non-current. How we calculate the current? 500 minus 500,000 minus next year interest. How much is the next year interest? 308,000. into 308. So the answer is 192,000. And then the non-current portion, what do you do? 3075,000 minus 192. That gives you your non-current portion. This is your non-current portion. Current portion is 192. Non-current portion is 288,300. That's how we divide into two sections. So closing lease credit equal opening lease credit plus interest minus installment. Okay. So shall we go to that? Go to your statement of financial position. Current portion 192. Lease creditor 192,000. Non-current portion 2883. And then go to expense, lease interest. Finance 325,000. Finance cost 325,000. Note number 1. Lease interest 325. Lease interest 325,000. Okay. Next. The company wrote off additional bad debts 10,000. So write it here. Expense schedule. Bad debts. Distribution 10,000. Go to debtors. Minus 10,000. Now go to the trial balance. Go to the trial balance and tell me how much is your trade receivable. Trade receivable is 360. So trade receivable is 360. 360 minus 130. 360 minus 130, answer is 230. Okay. So 230 is the answer for creditors. Sorry, creditors. And further they mention you are allowing expected losses from account receivable 5%, taking 5% calculator is into 11,500. Allowance for expected losses 11,500. Allowance for expected losses from account receivable 11,500. Now go to your trial balance. Go to your trial balance and tell me what is the opening provision. Opening provision is 5. Closing provision is 11,500. So what is the increase in provision? 6,500. So go to your expense schedule. Increase in expected losses. 6,500. Increase in expected losses from debtors or account receivable, 6,000. We missed the income tax part. Okay. Income tax paid during the year include 53,000 paid with respect of the previous year. Total income tax liability is 175. Okay. Go to your trial balance. Please draw this one. The easiest way you can figure out the income taxes. Tell me, go to your trial balance and tell me how much you paid income tax. How much you paid your income tax? You paid income tax 223. You paid income tax 223. Okay. And out of this 223, how much you paid for the last year? How much you paid for the last year? 53. So last year you paid 53. So 223 is for the entire thing. Last year you paid 53. How much you paid for the current year? 223 minus 53,000. Answer is 170,000. You paid last year 53 and you paid last current year 170. Clear? Clear? Now, what is the last year provision? What was the last year provision? 23. So provision 23,000. Provision 23,000. You paid last year 253. Provision 23. Is it an over provision or under provision? It's an under provision. How much? 30,000. Under provision is 30,000. Under provision is 30,000. Yeah. the provision is 30,000. And further, they mention in your income tax note, total income tax liability for the year ending whole year is 175. Total income tax liability is 175. Yeah. So go to so you paid 170 for the current year. The total liability is 175. So the provision is how much? 5,000. Provision is 5,000. So go to your current liability, income tax payable 5,000. Income tax payable 5,000. Income tax payable 5,000. Okay. And go to your income tax note, provision for the year. 175 provision for the year 175. How much was the under provision? 30. So what do you do with the under provision? You add 30,000. The answer is this plus this 205 that goes here. Income tax minus 205. Income tax minus 205. Ninth one. The company rented and paid a storage warehouse for the year with the rental period commencing on 1st October 2020. The amount paid was 24,000. So what happened? They pay for the whole year, starting from 1st October 2020. Your financial year ends on 31st March 2021. So you pay upfront for the 6 months. Clear? So write it here. So that has been included in, I guess it's in the admin expenses. So admin expenses include, so go to here. I'm under admin expenses. Prepaid rent. Under admin expenses, you put minus 12,000. Under admin expenses, you put minus 12,000. Go to current assets. Go to current assets. Prepaid rent. Prepaid rent 12,000. Okay. So this is a separate note. So just make a note, note number 6. You will get some marks for this one. Note number 6. A final dividend. Say a final dividend. Of 50 cents have been declared. Just right. Final dividend of 50 cents have been declared. And you to transfer 500,000 to general reserves. So go to statement of financial post, statement of changes in equity, transfer to general reserves. You put minus retained earnings 500,000. You put 500,000 here. Yeah. Okay. So in your exam, if you cover this, that is more than enough. Okay. It's a matter of getting the trial balance, you put it here, and you can calculate the cost of sales, and you can check the sales figure, cost of sales, gross profit, and you come up with the final answer here. Final answer, you need to put it the administrative expenses as per the trial balance, 250,000. And as per the trial balance distribution expenses, 287. So you need to come up with the final answers here and put it in the values. You get the answers here. So I'll stop with this because it's a matter of copying your trial balance and putting it in the accurate places. So we have done almost all the adjustments. You might get one or two, sometimes five or six, but these are the type of question or adjustments that you need to practice. Yeah. So I'll give you a 5-minute break, and after that, we'll move on to a partnership accounting. Okay. So have a break, 5 minutes, and we'll start 9:52. Please come up sharp 9:52. We'll start partnership accounting. So I'll stop with this because I don't have much time to proceed with the in and out. I don't want to balance it because we have done almost all the areas. So I think you have a practice of doing company accounting once. This is a bit hard one, but the implications can be tested in your examination, especially in PPE note. The revalued assets, depreciated revalued assets, exchanging assets, disposals, additions can be tested. Okay. In the meantime, just draw income statement, partner's current and capital account, and statement of financial position. Just draw the format. I request from you not to leave, but some of them are leave. I don't know why, because it's your exam. Okay, it's your exam. So please stay. It's only half an hour's time or 45 minutes probably. Just stay, because you will learn a lot. Okay, so important areas, so important topics. It's not my exam. It is your exams. Okay. And you would take this one as a second time. You might do second times or third time. No, you need to do this time. Finish it off. Okay. So you struggle a lot. So this is the last couple of months or 1.5 months or probably. So please make use of it. Time is so precious. Please draw income statement and partner's capital account, partner's current account. So this is the combination of partnership with incompleted records. Can be tested. Not tested, I think in 2018 it was tested, but after that it didn't test. I'll give you a brief on partnership. Partnership, nothing much. So it's about profit. So you calculate your sales, revenue. You start with revenue, cost of sales, gross profit, expenses, net profit. A net profit take a share of partners like atare in the form of either salaries, interest on capital, and profit share. That's all. The profit, you shared among partners in various forms, namely salaries, interest on capital, and profit share. But when it comes to the equity section, so you have two elements. One is partner's capital account, other one is partner's current account. So partner's capital account, mainly the capital they provide to the partnership, plus if there are any kind of a changes in partnership partners, sometimes the partner might retire, sometimes the partner might, new partner might join into the business. In that case, you need to do some kind of adjustments pertaining to goodwill. So a changes tika karanna tamai partner's capital account ekata. On the other hand, the short-term relationship in the form of salaries, interest on capital, profit share, drawings, interest on drawings, those type of things will be recorded in partner's current account. That's all about partnership, nothing new. Yeah. Right. We'll read the question. This is a bit weird question, but this question can come either two partners or one partners. It's different way, but the logic, the extensiveness of the question, the areas can be tested. Please do this one and you will learn a lot. Okay. Amal, Kamal, Nimal are in partnership sharing profit and losses in the ratio of 3:2:1 respectively. The partnership balance sheet as at 1st April 2020 is given below. May dheera thiyene opening balance sheet. That is the opening balance sheet ekak dheera thiyena ma. They give some information here. Don't do anything. Just read. Just do a skim reading. Okay. And this one, additional information. On 1st April, Kamal retired from the partnership. Now, Kamal retired when the first day itself. First day, me retire when the mukata pikaran no. Kamal ki tiye na partnership ke capital account ekai, current account ekai, transfer when the loan account. That's a normal thing. So, eva tiko loote. On 1st April 2020, Kamal retired from the partnership. It was agreed by other partners to admit Vimal as a partner to the partnership, paying a sum of 500,000. So now you have a new partner as well. The new partnership agreement provided as follows. Profit and losses should be shared equally. 12% interest per annum will be allowed for fixed capital, that is interest on capital. Was agreed by all partners to maintain a fixed capital of 400,000 each other, and adjustment need to be adjustments of any deficits or surplus through current accounts. Then the goodwill is valued at 120,000 to be adjusted in the partner's capital account. And on retirement, Kamal was paid a sum of 150,000 and was allowed to take over motor vehicle of which carrying value is 40,000, cost is 100,000, agreed value is 30,000, stock of 60,000, part payment of the amount due to him. Kamal agreed to keep the balance due to him for him as a long-term loan to the partnership. So all receipts and payments is given. So it's basically the cash account, you know, leave it. The non-current assets should be depreciated following manner, plant and equipment. This is depreciation part that. You know, closing balances, you know, stocks, you know, activities, you know, paid receivable balances, you know, allowance, you know, paid creditors, long-term loans have been paid. Prepare partnership capital account, current account, income statement, appropriation, financial position. So I might not be able to do all. If time permits, I'll try my level best to cover. Okay. So first thing is do open that capital and current account opening balances. So go to your capital accounts, take down the balance. Amal 500, Amal 350, Nimal 225, and the other one is called Vima. Opening balances, take down current account, debit balances. Amal 50, Amal 40, Nimal 20. Right. Goodwill was valued 120. ඒ ලේසි ටික මුලින්ම කරන්න. Capital account එකට ගිහිල්ලා ලියන්න goodwill. So 120, what is your old PSR? 321. So 120 බෙදන්න 6ෙන් 20. 20 into 3 60. 20 into 2 40. 20 into 1 20. And goodwill debit karan. New profit sharing ratio. So who is the retiring partner? Kamal. So Kamal කියන එක පොඩ්ඩක් මෙතන highlight කරලා. Is the outgoing partner. So profit and losses are shared equally. Goodwill is 120. 120 divided by 3, 40. 40. ඒ සේවා ටික මුලින් කරන්න. හරිද? Now it's mentioned the new partner Vimal brings 500,000. So go to your cash account. Vimal metana thiyena 500,000. Metana liyana cash kiyala Vimal 500. Vimal 500. Vimal 500 cash. And further it mentioned it was agreed by all partners to maintain a fixed capital of 400,000. The capital balance ekak kiyawenna oneida? Liyana balance kiyala. Outgoing balance එක වෙන්න ඕනේ 400. Outgoing partner 400. ඒකේ difference එක adjust කරන්න ඕනේ capital current account එකේ balance. හරි දැන් capital account එක balance කරන්න. 560 here. Leave it, come out. 40. So you put it current. Current again or balance ticker. Minus. 120. Here the balance is 440. Balancing figure is 400. 40 minus 20 minus 225. Current. This is 500. Current. දැන් යන කරන්ට් account කියලා මේක කරන්ට් නා එතන capital කියලා ලියන්න. Amal 120. Vimal 60. Capital. Yeah. 195. ඊට මේකේ opposite එක විදිහට දාන්න. මේක තමයි capital එක. So they are maintaining a fixed capital. හරිද? හරි දැන් ලියන්න interest on capital කියලා ලියන්න. Interest on capital. Interest on capital කියලා ලියන්න. What is the interest on capital here? They agreed with 12%. So the answer is 400 into 12%, 400 into 10% is 40. So you put 48. That is the interest on capital. Now go to your appropriation account. You put ANV. ANW. 48. So you adjust your interest on capital part then and there. On retirement, Kamal was paid a sum of 150 yen cash. Cash giver 150. And take over motor vehicle for agreed value of 230. So liana motor vehicle 30. Motor vehicle 30. And stocks. Stocks 60. As a part payment due to him. So can you calculate the Kamal balance? Hold on a second. The Nimal current account balance is 280,000. Hold on a second. Nimal current account balance is positive. Yes. Now we are trying to figure out the closing balance for the Kamal. The Kamal gave, we figure out the value here. So methana thina 390 capital account. Okay. Here you take and directly transfer the current account in capital account as well. Hold on a second. Current account balance ekathina methana 40. So you put it to the capital account. LE, and here you put it current. Are it 390 total opening balance 350 plus 40 390, so you put 390 here. Either closing balance dana loan account take a transfer venawa. Put it on loan account. This is equal 390 minus 30, 150, 40. So loan account is 110. Now go to the balance sheet. Statement of financial position. Non-current liability. Kamal's loan 110. So normally under section 42 partnership ordinance, if any partner retires, any outstanding amounts are supposed to pay with an interest of 5%. That is to make it a 5% here. 5.5. So go to your finance expense. Interest on Kamal's loan minus 5.5. And go to accrued expenses under current liability. Go to accrued expenses, accrued loan interest. Are there? Then here you have a motor vehicle. Motor vehicle carrying amount is 40, agreed value is 30. So loss on motor vehicle. Go to other expenses. Loss on motor vehicle 10. Loss on motor vehicle 10. මෙතන stocks අරගෙන තිනවා 60 purchases වලින් ඒක අඩු කරා purchases minus 60 purchases minus 60 yeah purchases minus 60 right next one so You have your opening debtor. Opening debtors like you know. Receive from debtors, you know. Closing debtors like. So can you calculate the sales here? You need you can use the key account. So opening debtor. How much is the opening debtor? 120. So you put 120 here. Closing debtor 200. The cash you receive from debtors, you credit here 3,200. 3,400 minus 120. 3,400 minus 120. You get 3,280. That is your sales here. That is your sales. And then allowance for doubtful debts. So allowance for doubtful debts is 200. Closing balance is 200 debtors lage. So A king 10%, that is 20 here. Go to your current assets. Yes, 200 allowance minus 20. Allowance like a minus 20. Are there? And what is the opening allowance? Opening allowance is 6. 6 become 20. So increase in allowance. Distribution cost. Increase in allowance. Increase in allowance. 6 to 20, 40. 6 to 20, 40. Right. We'll check the purchases figure. So opening creditor. Opening creditor. Is 90. Opening creditor is 90. Closing creditor. Closing creditor. Closing creditor is 110. Closing creditor is 110. And payment to suppliers 2100. Cash credit debit this 2100. So what is the purchases figure? Which is equal 2100 plus 110 minus 90. The purchases is 2120. The purchases is 2120. So go to the cost of sales 120. Okay. Right. Now go to the balance sheet, current liability, creditors. Creditors. Put it here. 110. And write it down next, accrued expenses. Accrued expenses. 19.5. Equity expense is 19.5. Same way creditor. Your opening accrual is 14. Opening accrual is 14. Closing accrual expenses 19.5. Cash you pay, cash credit debit this one. How much? 600. So can you calculate the expenses here? P&L. P&L amount of expenses equal this plus this minus 14. Operating expenses 605.5. Operating expenses 605.5. Drawings debit current account. Drawings you debit. Amal 80. Nothing for Kamal. Nimal 50. Vimal 20. So you settle the bank loan. So bank loan interest is a current expense, finance cost. Interest on bank loan. So your initial bank loan is 400. 400 into 50% 30. So you pay that 30. That's the interest on bank loan. So opening stocks 120. So write it here. Opening stocks 120. Purchases figure is 2120 minus 60. Stocks. Closing stocks. $550. Right. Property, plant, and machinery. Sorry, plant and machinery. 10% on cost. 10% on cost. Plant and machinery. 10% on cost. Plant depreciation. Plant depreciation. You put 50 here. Plant depreciation. 50. And motor vehicle is a bit tricky, okay? Motor vehicle carrying amount is 90. And Kamal is taking a motor vehicle with a carrying amount is 40. First day itself. Opening motor vehicle theenama carrying amount, okay? So if you take the carrying amount of the motor vehicle is 90. Out of 90, carrying amount of 40 taken over by Kamal. Remaining the 50. And motor vehicles are depreciated at a rate of 20% on reducing balance method. So making 20% key 10. Write it down. Depreciation on motor vehicle. Depreciation on motor vehicle. Okay. I'm not bothered about the balance sheet. We'll focus on the calculation of profit part. So write it. Now go to the balance sheet. Current assets. Land as it is. Land you put 850. Plant and machinery, it's 500 minus 370. 100 minus 320 plus 50, 370, 130. And motor vehicle, 50 valing 10 giyama, carrying value ekata dam. Hari. Office equipment. Did they mention anything about office equipment? 10% on cost. So office equipment depreciation, depreciation on office equipment. 10% on cost, that is 16. Depreciation on office equipment, 10%, 16. So the carrying value at a pahang das ekaduka. We have taken everything. Okay, calculate gross profit, cost of sales. This is the gross cost of sales. The gross profit is equal to sales minus cost of sales. And then expenses, you take all the expenses here. And the profit. Minus figure. And this goes here. Opening stock is 360. My mistake, yes, 360. Profit share. Divide it. So, my advice, you take any figure, you take this divide by 3. Even though it's a wrong figure, make sure you divide by 3 because profit and losses are shared among them equally. And then what you do is, you go here or write it profit share. Okay. You put 178.6. Don't need to balance 178.6. 178, not this one. 178.6 and 178.6. Okay. So, this don't worry too much on this question. This is the question that carries that check your knowledge pertaining to your partnership and as well as the incomplete records. Okay, so I don't think you might get 4 partners or 2 partners or 3 partners. That I don't know how criticality she want to test in your exam, but prepare for the worst. So if you prepare for the worst, you can make up your mind and you can proceed with your exam during your examination time. Okay, regard to the paper structure and how you plan your next couple of days. You need, so we need to have, yes, you're right. 400,000 loan, yes, you need to calculate. So if you take the calculate 400,000 loan, it is 400,000 15%. So 400,000 15%, it is 430. So it says here, loan you settle along with the interest. This is the bank statement. So loan you settle along with the interest, and further it's mentioned long-term loan have been paid in full during the year. It means I have taken into consideration here in under finance cost, interest on loan 30. Yeah. So yeah, please allow me to discuss your next couple of days and how you need to plan. Okay, so my advice these days, any subject, you need to do model papers, you need to just skim read, practice your paper questions, and make sure you know this area. If you know this area, you're done. But if you're not sure about, if you have any gray areas, you come up with some sort of uncertainty and you find it difficult, so please do that, particularly those areas that can be repeatedly tested. So if you are not started studying yet, you can still focus on the areas that are repeatedly tested. So focus on those areas, especially in terms of accounting. I would say company accounts, partnership, accounting equation questions, bank, prime entry books, overhead analysis sheets, and profit volume analysis, and basically project appraisals. So those areas repeatedly test. So please focus on these areas which are repeatedly test, and easily you can score these marks. And don't worry about the speed at this stage. If you are a beginner, I'm telling you, if you're not studied and if you are planning to study, focus now and going ahead with the studying part. So please don't focus on your speed. So you need to first learn first, okay? And if you are score around 60 to 70 or 70 to 80, your target should be the speed next. So try to come up with the answers without wasting much time. So then only you can achieve your competitive edge, clear? So today is my last day. So Ali would take the next areas pertaining to the management accounting. And in the meantime, if you have any doubts, I'll give my contact number. You can call and at any time you can ask. Especially your exams will be, I think it is 23rd and 27th of February. So you have ample time for accounting. So if you need any clarification, this is my number. You can contact me at any time. Okay. And I don't know to what extent your examiner might test, but I suggest you need to go through your reporting framework part, the theory, accounting concepts, accounting standards, because she allowed to test accounting standard area, conceptual framework, accounting concepts. Very, very important. She might not test the numerical part, she might test the theoretical part. Okay, so there are some theoretical aspects, theoretical areas that can be tested. So most of the students are last time they have lack of knowledge pertaining to those areas, especially for conceptual framework of financial reporting. Conceptual framework, a key area, her favorite area when it comes to the university or whatever. So she will again test the areas, those areas the 2020 students not scored much. So please brush up your areas, those areas, and make sure you score company accounting well, because there's a tremendous competition between you and your second shy, your elders. Okay, so second shy people, the one who has already done and doing second time. So they have the experience and they know their mistakes. So they have already done the papers, but when it comes to you, you might not have much practice. So that lack of practice should not be the reason to fail. So you have ample time. So focus on the remaining time, have a timetable properly and stick to that discipline. And that discipline triggers to get a good score in your financial accounting and a good score in your ICET score even. Harith, do you have any doubts, any chance? So if you have any doubts, my email address is okay. So this is my contact number, this is my email address. Feel free to come up with any kind of a thing. Probably I might do my own seminar. It's a kind of a physical seminar, but it's a kind of a through online, not like this. It's a kind of a in a studio. I will text you the dates, and probably I might discuss another kind of MCQs, the paper one and paper two, two separate dates prior to probably end of January. I'll inform you the dates, and so that you can get some kind of a most probable questions I want to cover. And don't be kind of a demotivated. The questions are tough. I purposely prepare this one so that you know what your standard is, what the area you lack. So by doing this type of a questions, you need to know what are the areas you need to improve, the areas that you need to focus more, likewise. Clear? So all the best for your exams, including your economics and business studies. I think economics is the initial couple of days, a couple of weeks, you have economics and business studies. So please do focus on, when it comes to February, from February 1st to the initial initial weeks, you need to focus more on the economics and business studies, because you have ample time to do accounting part, because it's in 23rd and 27th, if I'm not mistaken. So please be positive. Please, if you're not studied yet, this 1.5 months is more than enough to get a good score. There are so many my students of mine got good results. This time is more than enough. Be positive and have a target. Please work on this. And always be positive, remember. Don't have any sort of a negative attitudes. Always be positive. I know it's a kind of a dilemma of your age and your batch, 2021 batch. I know it's a tricky thing, but it's common for everyone. So all are in the same boat, remember. So all are in the same boat. Try to differentiate you from others. So how you differentiate? So that is only way is discipline. So you need to make up your mind and be positive and motivate yourself and have a firm affirmations, positive affirmations every day, and please live it. Always have a dream of getting 3 A's. Always have a dream of getting a good island rank. That is your dream. So you need to achieve that dream and make your parents and your school proud across the nation. Okay. So I'll stop with that, and all the best, my dear students. Thank for Nanaska to give me this opportunity to address you and helping you all. I think we have done a great job and helping those who are struggling in the last moment still. And I believe I did kind of a good job. And if you have any doubts, feel free to come up with any doubts or problems. I'm happy to help at any time. Okay, all the best. And God bless you all. Thank you.